Hey beauties, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we'll be discussing three different kinds of chemical peels that you can easily do at home. We'll talk about their ingredients, the skin concerns they each target, differences between them. That way you'll be able to decide which is the best chemical peel for your skin. A little over a year ago in my current skincare routine video, which I know is due for an update, I mentioned that I regularly do peels at home, and I've been using Perfect Image peels for roughly 5 years or so now. I partnered with them to create today's video, so these products were sent to me complimentary. However, I have purchased many of their peels in the past. I will continue to purchase their peels well into the future for one quite simple reason: they're incredibly effective. Here I have a Salicylic 20% gel peel. I also have the Lactic Acid 50% gel peel. Last but certainly not least, I have a Glycolic Acid 30% gel peel. And when you look at the bottle, there's a lot of really great information, the ingredients, but you'll also see a level. So the Salicylic and the Lactic Acid peels are both level 2, and the Glycolic Acid peel is a level 1. When you search the Perfect Image website, you'll see that the different acid peels come in different levels or different strengths. And depending on the sensitivity of your skin, that will tell you which level you should choose. You'll also find a wide variety of chemical peels to choose from. These are the three that I personally love and have been using for years and continue to use because they each do something slightly different. I love adding a chemical peel to my skincare routine because it can just improve the appearance of your skin overall. Plus, it can target a specific concern, whether it be post-blemish marks, pores, texture. I also love these peels because they're fortified. So here, if I'm looking at the glycolic acid peel, this is enhanced with retinol and green tea extract. They're also far more cost-effective than having a series of peels done at a spa or a dermatologist's office. Something important to keep in mind when you do have chemical peels done outside of the home, it's usually done by a professional who's following very strict guidelines. And you have to take that same mentality when you're doing these peels at home. So no going off script, no going rogue. You really have to be careful to follow the instructions, read the labels incredibly carefully. So I'm gonna go through each peel and describe each one, and then I'm going to follow up with a demonstration. Beginning with the Salicylic 20% gel peel enhanced with tea tree oil and green tea extract, this is a level 2 peel. It retails for $29.95, I believe, on their website, and you get 1 fluid ounce. This is the peel that really started it all for me. It was truly the gateway drug that got me hooked on all of these peels. Several years ago, I was struggling really bad with hormonal breakouts and acne, and a friend of mine who was previously a spa director up in New York City, she had flawless skin, recommended this to me. I did my first peel, and I think I immediately went on their website and ordered the other 2 peels because I just completely fell in love. So this is going to be a peel that's best suited for anybody who's really acne prone or looking to treat blemishes. The Salicylic destroys bacteria below the surface, helping to unclog pores through exfoliation. The tea tree oil and green tea extracts contain powerful antifungal, antibacterial, and antiviral properties. So this is going to be a peel that's going to help visibly improve the appearance of acne, blackheads, whiteheads. It's going to help clarify active breakouts and generate less irritation. Since my skin now is less acne prone than it used to be, this isn't a peel that I grab for quite as often, but it's still something that I always like to have on hand as my emergency SOS must have. There was a period of about 6 months between the time that we were moving from Tennessee down to Florida that I was constantly breaking out and dealing with those horrible cystic blemishes on my chin. And this is a peel that I really relied on to kind of hit the reset button and get my skin back on track. I'm sure it was due to just constant stress, which happens from time to time. Even though I'm not a teenager and I'm not dealing with breakouts and acne the way I used to, I still will occasionally go through periods where I definitely grab this peel. This is also one of the peels that I do experience flaking of the skin. So a couple days after I've done the peel, I'll still notice some light flaking and a little bit of peeling. Not the worst thing in the world. I just double up on my moisturizer and I stay patient because I know underneath is new, fresh skin. Next up, we have the Lactic Acid 50% Gel Peel. This is enhanced with kojic acid and bearberry extract. It also retails for $29.95 and it's a level 2 peel. It's a little bit thinner, it's less thick than the Salicylic Acid Peel, and it's darker in color, of course. Also, you'll notice that up in the corner it says tone, whereas the Salicylic Acid said clear, and that's because this peel is intended to help even out your skin tone. Lactic acid promotes stimulation of collagen production while increasing cell turnover for a more brightened and balanced texture. The kojic acid is an inhibitor of melanin and has been successfully used to reduce freckles, fight age spots, pregnancy marks, stretch marks, acne, and pigmentation conditions of the face and body. It's infused with botanical extracts of bearberry and licorice, which provide natural skin lightening. Anytime I've gone through a period of extended breakouts and blemishes, once they're healed, I'll still be left with post-blemish marks, and that's when I grab this peel. If you're somebody who struggles with hyperpigmentation or discoloration on your face that makes you self-conscious, this would be the perfect peel to work into your skincare regimen. It's not going to completely clear the slate after just one use, but you will see dramatic results if you work this in. I would start with maybe once every other week, especially if you're sensitive, then you could build it up to once a week, maybe twice a week, and you're certainly going to see results a lot faster than if you had just been relying on topical creams and serums. So this is also great because it is going to help with texture, pores, fine lines, but certainly if you have dark spots, this is the right peel for you. The third and final peel I have to talk about is the Glycolic Acid 30% Gel Peel, enhanced with retinol and green tea extract. As you can see, this is considered to be a level 1, so it's not going to be quite as strong or as harsh as the previous two. Like the Salicylic, it's clear in color, but the texture and consistency is much thinner and more watery than the other peels, which is important to note when you're applying this to the skin because you don't want it to drip all over the place. You want to keep these peels nice and controlled when you're applying them. In the top corner, it says age because this peel is best suited to target the signs of aging, so fine lines and wrinkles. The glycolic acid safely and effectively reduces the appearance of wrinkles, fine lines, and other signs of aging. It increases cellular turnover, removing dead and dull surface cells for a smoother, more refined appearance. The glycolic peel has eclipsed the salicylic peel to become my number one favorite of the three. So this is what I'm grabbing most often if I'm doing a peel at home. So now I'm going to demonstrate, and as I mentioned previously, you have to be very careful to follow instructions. Do not stray away from them. The consequences can be somewhat severe, so it's worth repeating that you really want to be very careful when you're doing your first peel at home. With some of these peels, you may experience some dryness and some peeling of the skin, while others you won't, but they are all professionally formulated. So even if you don't see peeling, don't worry, it is still working and it is removing millions of dead skin cells. The first step is to prep your skin. Before applying the peel, you need to wash your face and really degrease. Remove any oil, dirt, and debris. This salicylic deep gel cleanser enhanced with tea tree oil and green tea extract works well to clear away oil, which will allow the peel to penetrate and be more effective. If you have sensitive skin, you can use this cleanser twice a week. Other than that, you can use it 3 to 5 times a week. This is a deep exfoliating cleanser, so while it does have a silky foam, it's specifically formulated to thoroughly cleanse skin to prep for a peel. Once you choose your peel, have a timer ready to go. I always use my iPhone. To apply the peel, simply use the dropper to distribute the product on the main areas of the face, and then use the fan brush to smooth it across the skin so you get a nice, even layer. The first time you apply a peel, start with a patch test to see how your skin reacts. If it's okay, go ahead and leave the peel on for no longer than 1 minute. Once you've built up a tolerance and your skin gets used to the peels, then you can begin to layer. All you have to do is simply wait 1 minute and then add another dropper full of product and smooth it all over the skin. Never do more than 5 layers of a peel at a time. And to be honest, even when my skin is at its worst, I never do more than 2 layers. Now that it's been a little over 2 minutes, I'm going to rinse my face with cold water in the bathroom. You might feel a light tingle or a light burn, but it should completely disappear as soon as you remove the peel with cold water. And you'll want to pat dry, do not rub. Once your skin is completely dry, it's important to follow up with a rich moisturizer. And be sure to wear sunscreen with SPF 30 or above if you're going to go outside 1 to 2 weeks post-peel, because your skin will be extra sensitive. I personally love to rotate between the glycolic acid and the lactic acid peel. And then if my skin is really going through something, I'll throw in a salicylic peel to just hit the reset button and get my skin back on track. But your main skincare concern will really determine which peel is best for you. With continued use, and of course with anything skincare, consistency is key. You will see improved texture, a reduction in the appearance of fine lines, wrinkles, dark spots, post-blemish marks. They can really make a huge difference, and at-home peels are really an affordable way to upgrade your skincare routine. And that completes today's video. So thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you found it informative and helpful. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Leave me any of your comments or your questions down below. As always, I will be linking everything that I used today on my face, all of the information you need to know about the Perfect Image peels, down below in the description box for your convenience. And for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell.